Hi guys, welcome back to another update of the price action indicator. Today I want to show you a couple of new stuff, and if we have time I would like to go over all the settings once more. We have a lot of settings at the moment and it might be a little bit difficult for beginners to understand all of it. So if we have time I will go over them, and if not I will do it in another video next time. So basically we have two new things. Let's pause for a moment. That is traps and buy sell buttons. Let's go for the traps first. You will see that on the far right end we have a purple diamond right here, which indicates a potential trap, not potential. So when price is moving lower and breaking this line, it's a trap, and you could go the other way. You could take a 20 so you could take an entry there. Traps are also shown of course in the history, like here, also as a purple diamonds, and it says it if it's a short or a long trap. And well, just call back and you can see them. So that's new. Not much too more to say about those things, those traps. Well, maybe when will you be looking for a trap? That's maybe a good idea to explain. Let's say you are in a uptrend like this, right, and a second entry short appears right here. So we have a second entry short right here, and that could be a potential trap because you don't expect a second entry short in a uptrend. So when that second entry short fails in an uptrend, you could take a long, and that's basically what the traps are explaining. So they're shown. The other thing I wanted to show you is the buy sell and cancel buttons. These buttons allow you to open a trade. So if you press buy, it opens a buy trade. If you press sell, it opens a short trade. And if you press cancel, it cancels the trades. Very easy. When you open a trade using the buttons, it will use your account as you specify here, and it will use your ATM as you have selected. So that's also pretty easy to understand. The number of contracts you have on option here, by default it will use the number of contracts you specify here in your chart trader. But you can also choose to have it dynamically and use the number of contracts which get calculated by the indicator based on your position sizing. So for example, here this second entry short, we could have traded that with two contracts, and here we could have traded it with four, and here again with four contracts, and there with five contracts. So you can choose if you want to use the dynamic number of contracts or the number one you specify here. And the way you do that is by going to the settings, open the price action indicator. In there will be a new setting called order panel. You can choose to show or hide the entire panel. If you don't want it, just press disable and it will be gone, and if you enable it, it will again show up. You can choose where you want it to appear, on the top, left, right, or bottom of the chart. And you can use your, it says ATM, I have to rename that to contracts, I guess. So the number of contracts, if you want to use the NinjaTrader number of contracts, or the one from the indicator, which is basically the ones it calculates. So pretty easy. And let's see how this would work in real time. As you see, I am currently in replay mode. So we can quickly go over the market and pause it when we see something we like and try out these buttons for us. Well, we're now on a Monday morning, so I'm moving a little bit forward until we get some more action. Because as you can see, I'm now speeding up at 500 times and it's still very slow. Okay, so we are now at, let's see, 1:48, 2 o'clock. Let's move a little bit further so we have a little bit more volume. Three o'clock, 4 o'clock. And let's see if we get a little bit out of this out of this range we see here. Okay, we're approaching 7 o'clock. So let's see if we can find something. Move it, make it a little bit bigger. We can see a nice uptrend appearing. And now we'll just see if we can find a second entry. So maybe a little bit faster still because it's still not very fast. Come on. It doesn't want to give us an entry. Okay, ho, stop. So here we have a potential second entry short and a potential second entry long. So we have both. You can see the high here. We have a second entry long. And we have a low here with a second entry short and a second entry, a first entry short and a potential second entry short right here. So let's try the short. Why not? So to open a short trade, I just press sell down. You can see the ATM kicking in, and notice it chose the four contracts, which is also shown right here. And now we just have to wait until we either get in or not. And notice that at the moment our entry is right here on the open. Which is also below one tick below this signal bar. If this candle closes higher, then we will see that our entry will be moved to here. So if it keeps on going higher and it closes, we will see that the entry will be moving to this place. And if the number of contracts change, then we'll see that be changed here. So, well, let's just move forward, see what happens. And of course, if it's price comes to the open of the trade, then it will just open the trade. Okay, so here something happened. You saw the candle moving higher, which means that our stop loss needed for this trade now is this 14 ticks, and it calculated that you can only trade three contracts based on your account size and your position sizing. So it changed the number of contracts back to three. It was four and now it's three. Now it's still going higher. F- 600 ticks left, 500, 400. I'm hoping it will close higher. No, 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 don't go lower. Oh, yeah, we probably, oh, here we go. So let's move this arrow away. You can see that our entry was on this purple line, which was one tick below this bar. And now this bar just closed, and it closed one tick higher. So our trade moved one tick up as well. So it moved from here to here. And well, probably we now get an entry. So it, yep, we are opened. We opened the trade, and what you will see is that the stop will be moved automatically one tick above the signal bar, and there will be our. Let's just go a little bit faster. Don't mind if it's a loser or a winner. Just want to exit the trade now. Come on. Yeah, so that was the trade. And so that was a winner. Now we also have the another one appearing, which is the first entry long and a potential second entry long. So it's back to back, two trades in a row, or possibly. So since we are in an uptrend, I'm going to press buy up. Note it again places the trade right at the correct place. It uses the four contracts which it calculated. And again, we'll just have to see now what happens. So let's move it forward, see what happens. Again, if it keeps moving lower, we'll see the trade entry going lower, lower, lower. And well, if it already triggers here, then we're just entering the trade and our stop loss will be placed right here. Okay, looks like it wants to go lower, but we have a little bit of resistance here. No, this is going to enter. 200. 100. Come on. Yep, so we're in the trade again. Notice the stop loss, which gets put one tick again below the signal bar. The open and here the take profit. So from here on, we can just continue again and see what happens. Just move it forward. And come on, do your thing. How hard can it be? Okay, so that was that what trade. Still not a very nice one, but okay. That was that trade. Let's move a little bit further. I want to do one more. So let's wait until the next one. Clearly in an uptrend at the moment. Yeah. It's not giving us any setups. Okay, so here maybe setup coming. You can see clearly we're in an uptrend and we have a potential short setup. Normally I wouldn't take it, but for the demonstration purposes, I'm going to try to show you the sell button once more. So we have a low, first entry short. And if it breaks that, it's the second entry short. So I press sell again. And let's see what happens. Okay. Again, we are in. Stop at the one tick above the signal bar. And well, I doubt this is going to get its target. Because it's counter trend, it could be. Just going to skip it forward a bit. Because it's again looking a bit consolidating. Come on. So notice the conflicting signals now. We went short in an uptrend and after it found a second entry long. So now we have both the second entry long and the second entry short in play. And both also show potential traps. Come on, just do your thing. Okay, so that was that. A little bit sad that we don't get any good entries. It's just going up, down, up, down, up, down all the time. So maybe one more. Here's another one. Get a second entry long in an uptrend. Yeah. Okay. Stop is automatically placed at the correct position. And will this one go or do we still get? Okay. Yeah. Stop is moved to break even and the runner is taken out. I just guess you know now how it works, right? The cell just opens the cell. Cancel cancels it, the button up, the buy up opens a buy, the stop is being automatically placed, the number of contracts is automatically determined based on the position sizing or your ATM, and I guess that's it. So I think it's clear. Well, and the one thing you probably also saw is the trap marker which is placed, there it is. So there it is, alerting you on a potential trap. So that's it for today. I hope it's clear. If not, let me know. Put it in the comments. If you have questions or something, let us know also. Note that if you need some question, if you have some questions and you want to speak to me, the easiest way for me would be to if you use this go away, if you go to tradedevils.com and use this support thingy, because there you can real-time chat with us, and we are there most of the time, and if not we'll always answer you, and you'll get the answer back. So this would be the ideal place to ask questions if you have, but you can also ask them on YouTube or on Facebook. That's also possible. Okay, again, that's it for today. Hope you enjoyed it. If so, then give us a like up and subscribe to the channel. And goodbye for now, and have a nice weekend. Bye bye.